Time management sounds like something you prefer not to do. It's got connotations of rules and procedures. Well, let me expel all those fears for you right now. It's something that can simply be done in 5-minute stint at the end of every working day, so that the next day you're off and running without giving it a further thought. This is what I call stress-free productivity. Because we tend to overcomplicate things and think everything's important, hence creating stress. Well, trash that stress by knowing what you'll be working on the first thing tomorrow. The secret is to gather everything that's thoughts, ideas, and only arrange them into categories at the end of the day. Hence, you don't have to divert your mind from what you're currently performing. And let me emphasize, you arrange everything that you've gathered into categories at the end of the day so you can perform them the next day or at whatever date you nominate. Things that have no date can be recorded as notes, so you don't have to stress about you'll forget them either. In this video, I'll give you an overview of that procedure, and in the series following, I'll show you details on how to put all of those into action. And it's not brain surgery, and it'll take no more than 5 minutes at the end of each day. I'd implore you to stay watching to fill that gap in your working life. And I use the phrase gap, as you may have guessed from what I've said in the past. These are the three words that explain that activity: gather, arrange, and perform. And the real secret is all in the first word. You gather everything as a note, all in one place, as you think of it, so nothing diverts your attention from what you're doing at the time. And let me emphasize, you gather everything, work-related and personal items, it doesn't matter. It gets it out of your mind so you can perform what you're currently working on without the stress of having to remember. You then arrange those into categories at the end of each day. And in the following tutorials, I show you the nuts and bolts of how to get that into a digitized process. But if you're a paper person, no problem. You can use the same logic with paper and pencil if you wish. For now, I want to expand on why quick gathering is so important. This whole theory is based on David Allen's theory of getting things done. That's GTD. And you may ask, why do I call my process GAP? Well, in fact, it's a modification on David Allen's. I fill the gaps, though, by using a free-to-use software that's in front of you all day on your iPhone, Android, tablet, Mac, PC, web pages, or even the Apple Watch. Most people using the GDT process are using three digital apps, a note-taking app, a calendar, and a to-do list. I'm going to show you how to do this with only one piece of software that runs in sync on all your devices. And most of you will never need more than the free-to-use version. And even if you do opt for the premium version, it's only a low $27 a year. I've been working on the free-to-use version for the past 4 years and still don't really need the premium features, though I will show you in the following tutorials just in case you feel you need those features. The name of the app is ticktick and it runs on any and all of your devices. And let me be clear now, this video is not paid for by ticktick, nor will they have any say in what I include in this video or in the series that follows. And as an overview, you use the notes feature in ticktick for ideas and the task feature for things that need to have a time frame. And it's just simply a record of your ideas and thoughts. And the beauty of it all is, as I've said, you can enter them instantly from any of your devices, all in one place, and then arrange them into categories at the end of the day. It doesn't matter where you are or what you're doing during the day. You can dictate from your iPhone or your Android or even your Apple Watch if you've got one. You can gather emails that you've received from any email app and add that to ticktick. You can gather URLs or text from Chrome or Firefox or Safari and add it to ticktick. And they've even got extensions that let you view ticktick as well if you're on the web page. You can type notes and add them to ticktick from your Mac or your PC. Then, when you arrange all your notes gathered during the day, you can add them to the calendar or the to-do list in ticktick as a note or as a date-sensitive task. And then when you start the next day, everything's in order, ready for you to perform them. And I'll show you all of these procedures in the following tutorials. Just remember to spend a few minutes, and please give it time so you can get into the habit. You can even set up a habit in ticktick. It has a habits feature to help remind you. And now you've reviewed what you'll be doing in the next day, your brain will subconsciously chew on it overnight, and you'll have enhanced ideas when you start working in the morning. And over time, I'd advise that you let the gap theory evolve to suit your personal ideas. Don't feel you're restricted on what I say. Be adventuresome. But whatever, be consistent about doing the arranging every day. Gather everything as you come across it, arrange it at the end of the day for the next day or after, and it'll allow you to spend most of your time performing. It's all designed for your stress-free productivity. And in the next video, I'll cover the use of ticktick on a computer. And I hope you've learned lots, so please like, subscribe, and press the bell to be notified of those further tutorials.